Well, welcome back. It is called the Super Bowl of Auto Shows. The Detroit Auto Show kicks off next weekend, but this morning we have a sneak peek. National auto expert Mike Cottle is standing by live with us this morning with a look at never-before-seen cars, trucks, and concepts. Well, good morning, Mike. This is pretty exciting, huh?
Well, I'll tell you what, it is exciting. This is the biggest auto show here in North America. And tomorrow's the big news. It's the North American Car, Truck, and Utility Vehicle of the Year that will be announced. Now, I have hand-selected one specific vehicle for you. So I'm going to hold you to that in a minute. But let me tell you who these vehicles are that are going to be up for tomorrow. These are my bold predictions. The Genesis G70 will win in that car category. I love the exterior design. It's all about performance with this vehicle as well. In the utility vehicle category, look for the Jaguar I-PACE. It's all about electrification and autonomy with this vehicle. And then one of the most talked about trucks this year was the Ram 1500. I expect that to be your winner in the truck category tomorrow. But this is one of the vehicles that I've hand selected for you. This is the Jeep Gladiator. This is one of the most anticipated vehicles this year, and I'll tell you why. It's because of what's over my shoulder. It's actually a Jeep with a truck bed on it. So it's 100% Jeep and it's 100% truck. This thing is the ultimate off-road vehicle. 4x4, the doors come off, the windshield folds down, the roof comes off. This thing will go anywhere. The interior is refined. There's a lot of cargo capacity on the interior as well. Now, I want to jump to this vehicle right here. The Ford Explorer debuted here earlier this week at the auto show. Redesigned from the ground up, a 3-liter EcoBoost motor under the hood that gives you great fuel economy. I love this 10.1-inch screen on the interior. And they have something called terrain management on this vehicle that allows you to select whether you want to drive in snow, you want to drive in dirt, you want to drive on the street. So it adjusts the suspension to make it more of a comfortable driving experience. Now, this is another vehicle that I selected for you. It's the Lincoln Aviator. This is all about luxury and performance. This is not your grandfather's Lincoln. It's a 3-row luxury SUV, and they have this cool technology where you can use your cell phone to control the vehicle. So if you leave your keys at home and forget about them and fly across the country, your phone can serve as your key, not to mention it'll be electrified as well. And there's a 450 horsepower option under the hood. This is the Lexus LC Concept Convertible, and I love the exterior design of this. It's all about performance. It's all about luxury. Look at the sexiness of that vehicle. 22-inch wheels on it. They are calling it a concept. I will think that they will put the same motor under the hood, a 5-liter V8 that gives it plenty of horsepower. And we've all been talking about safety in the market right now. This is the Toyota Guardian technology, and this is their 4.0 edition. And this is based off a Lexus LH500. This is awesome. It's a 360-degree monitoring system on this vehicle that will actually speed up and slow down the vehicle autonomously, and the steering wheel will move you to the left and to the right to keep you in and out of your lanes as well. So it's a real cool technology. They believe in it so well that they're going to give it away to their competitors in the marketplace. So a lot of news here. What do you think about that Lexus?
I think I'm sold on that Lexus. And the car right behind you, that Jeep, how much does that run for?
Well, they haven't announced pricing yet, okay, on it, but it'll be competitive in the market. So I would expect starting price on this to be somewhere right around $30,000, maybe a little bit north of that. You get it fully loaded, it's going to be probably more than $40,000. But this thing is awesome. I love the design. I love what they've done with the truck bed on it as well.
I know. It looks like a lot of fun. Mike, thanks so much for joining us, and we will talk with you again over on Fox 28. Well, President Trump is looking at pulling thousands of us.